Everyone, it's RetroGamingNow. We're back with The Binding of Isaac, Afterbirth Plus. And in our last episode, we sacrificed ourselves to Mom so that we could, to Hutch. Just so we can lock some items and show you who Hutch is. And you can see, if you look, there's that little post-it note up there and it says what I've beaten. So the heart is Mom's heart. The downward, upside-down cross, the St. Peter's cross, is Satan. And the regular cross is Isaac. So I want to play as characters where I haven't beaten Mom's heart yet. So I'm going to do Samson. Because, remember, defeating various bosses with different characters unlocks different things. Linger Bean. Crying makes me toot. Don't know what that is. I also don't know what it looks like. Anyways, if you remember, the way Samson works is the more damage he takes, the more damage he does. I wonder if maybe that's like a... You know, if something walks over that does damage, I don't know. Still, there's definitely benefits to not taking a lot of damage, but, you know... If I do, it's not the end of the world. I have 3 hearts to begin with, which is not bad at all, and so I have a little bit of room for error. Okay, I don't have any... Oh, we can't get whatever that is, because we can't fly. We also don't have any bombs to get that chest. Let's see, yeah, there's one more room at least. Nope, okay. Alright, so we're just gonna leave it at that. We might get a bomb after this boss fight, maybe not, who knows. Probably won't get flight though. Little horn. Figure out what these little things do. I need to get him to touch it. Maybe it poisons him or something? Come on. It doesn't seem like they disappear. It does just look like maybe just does straight damage. I wonder if there's a limit to how many of them I can do. Yeah, it does look like they just actually disappear eventually. I don't know, this item might be a bit of a dud. Almost there. Whoa! Whoops. Well, I gained damage because of that. What do we have? Stem cell HP up, good. That's very helpful in this character. Bunch of portals. After this, I should show you there's actually a bestiary built into the game, so we can actually see what all these monsters are called. Yeah, there's a lot of different modes and things to do in this game, and so I've only really been mostly doing straight runs, but you know, there's some cool things you can do, like there's special seeds and stuff like that. And of course, there's challenges, and you'll see, oops, we're unlocking challenges every once in a while. So again, you see we're taking damage, but that's not the end of the world, because we are increasing our damage we do. We need to get a key. And you see we're growing redder and redder. I'm not sure we can get keys from fires, but coins are also useful. Now, remember, we faced Hutch in the last game, and I guess I'll just talk a little bit more about Hutch. The thing is, once you defeat Hutch, So first of all, it only spawns if you beat Mom's Heart in 30 minutes. And you unlock a bunch of things, like, obviously there's things to unlock from beating Hush, but I usually... It's just such a difficult boss, like, it has so much health, that there's a couple things I want before I consider facing, and one of those is to have, like, a wafer, so that it only does half a heart of damage, because remember, in our last run, we would have been fine if we had the wafer. We probably would have. We might have been close, but we've had a much higher chance. Or, you know, some sort of invincibility, you know. Or, you know, basically just very high damage. We need to have high damage, but also high health. And I'm going to use this to get this key, so I can go to the treasure room. You need to have everything going right, really, for an effective Hush fight. And so, this is a new game. I started a new game for this series, but I've played through the old game quite a bit. The poop. This is not... Oh, it's a terrible item. That was flush. Anyways, I've played through the old game quite a bit, and so... But even then, I've only defeated Hush 3 or maybe even 4 times. So we're gonna get it eventually. You know, a lot of times it's just tempting for me to just try it, because, you know, obviously I want to eventually... take it out, but it's not easy. It really isn't. Okay, we got one of those out of the way pretty quickly. All right, crackjacks, broken remote. This is gonna teleport me randomly, but whatever. Let's take it. Also, I got a health up. It looks like. That's good. Okay. Alright, some keys, always helpful. Oops. Okay, I think I know what this does now. I think each time I use my activated item, it teleports. Well, yeah, I can try this out in a minute. Yes. Okay. What do we have here? D10, reroll enemies. That is actually kind of useful also. More useful than, well, if I do it. Well, if I'm going to use the broken remote, I kind of want to actually have the poop one. Reroll enemies is kind of useful in some cases, but, what is that thing? Is it a glitch? I don't want to go through there in case it does damage. Anyway, so, as I said, reroll enemies is useful. I see what it does, though. It teleports me first. What is that thing? Is he... Looks like he's attacking them. Okay, so this is what I was trying to say. I want the ability to teleport, because you can do some useful things using teleportation. But the order is not that helpful to me, where it teleports and then rerolls enemies. I prefer it do the other way around. What is this thing, though? I have no idea what's out causing that. Sorry, I'm just trying to think about strategy, like, which am I going to take? Because the poop on its own is not helpful, but if I have a... Yeah, I don't know. D10 is just useful in a lot of cases, because there's some tough rooms to face. I don't know. I'll think about it. But for now, I'm going to keep using this. And the reason is, there's certain secret rooms you can actually only find if you teleport there. And so, A, I have the option of teleporting to a normal secret room. But also, there's that other secret room that I could get to. Hmm. And so I just want to give this as many shots as I can. Okay, and I might run out of space here. Okay, alright, okay, gotta go. I got stuck. Yeah, that was poor planning on my part. So, okay. We should replenish our health. And then I'll decide which I want to take in a minute. We did take a lot of damage there. But, whatever. I wish I knew what that was causing that fly to be there. I don't know if it's a glitch, but it's kind of useful, I think. Stain. Yes, these ones that just pop up are kind of tough. They can be tough, at least. Because they are moving, they do have movement patterns. It's just, I don't know where they are, you know. Oops. Also, I don't have a ton of free health, so I do have to be a little careful here. But I'm doing 8 damage thanks to my negligence. I guess that fly's gonna stay with us. It's really strange. I don't know what it is. Come on. The problem is it's just so tedious, you know, he spawns once and then he's gone. And like you'll walk into him again, like that. I don't know. I need to be really careful now. I guess she'll still should be fine, I just have to play very conservatively. You know, I just don't know what. I'm not sure which movement pattern is going to help me the most, like, survive. I saw him move up that way. So maybe if I encircle. Okay, this should do it. Come on. There we go. I just got to take out these guys. There we go. Mom's pearls, range and luck up. And I've decided I'm going to go and take the poop. I think that's a better option. But we can use this once more. Problem is, now our damage is back down to really low levels. Ooh, ugh. I do have to remember, I don't have a whole lot of health right now. But that fly is kind of nice. It's just like a turret. Let's see if I can move these guys closer to it. There we go. Okay, I want to find that fly and there we go. Move these guys in that direction. Okay. Keep on teleporting. You know, this teleportation is also useful when for situations like, woo, oh, no, that was very dangerous. Situations like if I'm in the womb and I want to get out as soon as I can just keep teleporting and hopefully eventually make it. I need to be very careful though, because I am one hit away from death. One thing I'm not sure about is if that fly's attack damages me. No, I'm not doing that yet. Okay, be very careful. let's get a health. Nope. Well, I can use this bomb. No, actually, I don't think I can get this key. Actually, I can, yeah. I didn't realize I had bombs. Teleport again? Nope. No hearts, but keys. Okay. I died. Alright, we're starting that again. It's just bad. Egghead. Conehead. Okay. So it took a lot of time in that last one. I'm gonna try to move a little bit more quickly on this game. Alright. So also I would like to face Hush again. Things have to be going well. But, you know, I guess it's just hard for me to avoid that temptation. Like, I know I'm probably gonna die, but I gotta try. I just gotta try, because who knows. But it just has so much health. So much health. Oh my goodness, it's hard. Alright, Larry Jr. We just got one big one, which will soon get broken up, probably from my attacks. Like snake. You gotta be careful not to take damage from him turning on me. Okay, so now there's two of them. Where did I get my soul heart from? It must have been this conehead thing. I can't remember what else conehead does. I wonder if there's a mod that has the original Binding of Isaac music. Thank you. I'll take Heart Up. I should check that. That's another thing about this game. There's mods to it. You know, I haven't even really talked about it at all, but I haven't even tried it, honestly, that much. But you can change, like, whole things about the game because people add new items, you know, new floors. There's so much, you know. And I've talked about why I'm playing this game, but part of it is just there's so much to do. That's kind of like little bite-sized chunks of the game. Yeah, I think I'm probably going to move on to Mist Revelation. Excuse me, not Revelation, Exile. That's going to be the next Mist game I'm going to play. I'm actually going to start that pretty soon. But, you know, for now, this is just sort of my time waster. Okay, well, this is the first floor. No, it's the second floor. But we're only 3 minutes in, according to my thing. I don't know, sometimes it's just fun to move with a sense of urgency. Just makes the game have a little bit more purpose to it. Alright. Finish out these couple of guys. I don't know if I mentioned what Infested Baby does, or I can't remember if it's Infested or Zombie Baby, but he just spawns flies every once in a while. He's not great. It's not terrible, but it's not great either. Hey, if I can avoid taking damage, we're gonna get double room. Yeah, then I took damage. I still looks like we're gonna get one though. These yellow flies move fast enough where it's tough to completely dodge them. And I guess we did get that little damage boost, so let's see what we have. Monstro. Easy boss. One way to save time, if we're trying to go quickly, is to get a Bible so we can avoid some of the more difficult boss fights of Mom's Heart and Mom herself. Okay, let's check our double room. We get speed and damage up, growth hormones, very good. We can get that Brimstone guy for 2, or we can get... Nah, I'm not gonna take it. I was hoping for like a pentagram in there, but I'm not gonna, don't see any in there. Okay. Caves 1, Curse of the Blind. So that means we don't know what any items are. Annoying, but not game breaking. There's no Curse of Darkness. I mentioned before, I hate Curse of Darkness. Wow, that was tough. Somehow got out of that. Okay, so we're doing 5 base damage, which is okay. And that'll only go up as we take damage. Okay. Let's finish these guys off. Ooh, I nearly got hit there. Alright, we'll save that soul heart. We're doing 5 minutes in, 6 minutes in. Yeah, if you do it right, it only takes a couple minutes to do each floor. But the thing is, the floors do get longer. Oh, no keys. Ugh. I could use a couple bombs to get to that chest, and I think I probably will. The only thing is there might be a better place to use the bombs later on this floor, but with 3 bombs, I'll still have 1 left over. So I'm going to do that. 1 and 2. And we might be able to get a key out of this, because we got a bomb back. Key's very useful, because we need to get to that treasure room. Okay, we need to dodge appropriately here. I think we're doing all right. There we go. Oh, shoot, we're not going to get a key. Unless we want to try out this challenge room, which I think I will do. It's going to take us some time. But we didn't get it. Oh well. Let's just power through these guys. Do you get flat penny? Not sure what that does completely. We're missing something. There it is. And that guy spawned on me. I'm lucky it chose not to give me that damage because of that. Okay, well. That was a waste. No keys. This happens sometimes, but I was pressing enter, pressing the wrong button. I might try just the straight, you know, aiming forwards instead of encircling them. Yeah, well, doesn't really matter. I still took damage. I think this must be what sets a champion Gertie, because it looks like it's champion. It's like a darker color, but I think the fact that it spawns boils behind it. In fact, it looks like it only spawns boils. I haven't seen it do any fire damage projectiles. Half chance of getting an angel room, though, so we can hope that goes well for us. HP up, but I think we forgot a soul heart in the last floor. Oh no, it's still there. Let's go grab that real quick. Missing a treasure room is pretty bad, but you know, there's enough bad to mediocre items where, you know, you could just think of it as, instead of missing a treasure room, it's just getting a bad item. Or multiple activated items in a run. So let's see, we're 9 minutes in, we're in Caves 1, so we have 3 floors. So we're on pace for 18 minutes. And if we were under 20 to defeat Mom, we can do Boss Rush. Okay. These are going to be the most important. These, portals. Oops. So if you're trying to move quickly, Azazel is the best character because it deals the most damage the fastest immediately. So like it does a lot of damage very early on, whereas with other characters it takes time to upgrade and get to that. You know, Azazel is always risky just because of the soul heart situation, but... But it's pretty, you know, it's pretty... If you said I need to beat the game as fast as I can, I would do Azazel. Okay, we got a key, so at least we're gonna get treasure room out of this one. Sometimes I'm not quite sure how I dodge these guys. Alright, there's our treasure room. We need to get these portals out of the way. Portals are still there. Okay, now they're gone. I'm taking a lot of damage, but it'll help us out, I guess. So we have piggy bank. Don't know what that did. Gave me some coins. It's something to do with coins. Maybe we can see if we can figure it out. Okay. 12 coins. 13 coins. I don't know. I kind of want to save this key, but we might end up using it. These guys have a lot of health. But if you stay far enough away from them, you can dodge their attacks fairly easily. Actually, no, it's a bomb for 2 coins, not quite worth it. I usually say 3.5 per bomb. Nah, let's do it, why not? Nope. Oh! That went a lot farther than I expected. We have an arcade. Okay, so then I'll... Okay, I know what Flat Penny does. It makes it so I get keys from coins. Let's just blow these up. So, yeah, with all these keys, I might as well go check out the shop. And enough coins. Get Big Beautiful Fly? Why not? Or Hive Mind. Giant spiders and flies. Hive Mind, yeah. That's going to be helpful with this zombie baby. Starting to slow down a little bit. Alright, let's get these guys out soon. Because I hate this bomb. Yeah, these guys. Okay. Yeah, we can definitely see that our flies are doing a lot more damage. Chub. Yeah, I'm going to try without even bothering to take out those guys, and yeah, that worked out. It was a nice run. Let's see, Midnight Snack. It's HP up. Very helpful with this character. Moving on. Okay, so we have 2 floors to go. And we're at 13 minutes. We'll be close. Impossible? No. But close. Wow, those... Oops. Yeah, these spiders are really good. I'd like to get another item that spawns spiders. Okay, and I figured out what Piggy Bank does. When I take damage, I drop coins. I'm gonna take Faith up. I have enough keys now. Oh. Yeah, I'm gonna do this. With all these keys we have, what do we have? The world? Yep, might as well do it now. Probably should have saved that for the womb, but I'll take... meh, whatever. Oops. We're gonna get, what is this? Thunder Thighs. HP speed down. This allows us to destroy rocks. We should actually, get to the secret room real quick. And we'll just head straight in the other direction. Greed. Do a lot of damage, don't we? 6 damage. A lot of coins, too. Okay, well, that's... First of all, we can go in here for free Wheel of Fortune. But also, we can... Since we just saw Greed, we shouldn't see Greed again if we go to the shop. I wonder if my... Did my Thunder Thighs do damage up? Like, don't recall. The lovers. This might be useful at some point. What do we have here? We could get a soul hearts, pack of cards, or we could donate. We should just donate real quick. Time wasting, but whatever. Yeah, it might be close. I'm not going to take that soul hearts. We have the lovers and we have a sack. Let's see what the sack has. Key. Use lovers now. Lovers. Oh, skeleton key. It's not going to help us now. Alright. Monster 2. I like to destroy these skulls. I don't want to accidentally spawn a host, is what they're called, I think. And Hanged Man, this will be useful at some point. Oops. Just got caught off guard. Ooh. Twice, actually. Thrice. I always forget about that attack he does. Wow, this was not a good boss fight, was it? So I limit the rest of the damage. Mom's coin purse. Since there's 2 of these, we'll use it. Lemon Party. Doesn't do anything. Hanged Man. What do we have? Hanged Man and Wheel of Fortune. Use Wheel of Fortune now. Blow it up. And we'll take Tang Man down. Yeah, it looks like we might not have time. To defeat Mom under 20 minutes. That's okay though. Okay, I'm not gonna go there, it's just a sacrifice room. An arcade. I don't know how I avoid taking damage, that was good. Lucky or good, who knows. These flies are helpful. Oops. Could get monstros. Whatever that is. We can check out this card. Might as well do that. Justice. Justice is good. Might as well just take this now. Alright, blast assists. Pretty easy. Alright, this guy will charge if he sees us like that. Okay. Keep on moving. These guys are quite annoying because I can't take them out. Yeah, we're not going to make it. So that means I can slow down to make sure to find the treasure room. I keep forgetting that I have this thunder thighs. Oops. There's a lot of these. Sometimes it's nice to have rocks just as barriers, so I mean, you don't always want to destroy everything. Oh no, oh no! Yep, I knew that was gonna happen. Two clubs, might as well take that. Not gonna go to the boss room yet. High Priestess. That'll be useful eventually, not right now. Not for this fight, at least. Okay, how am I going to get out of this room? I'm not, is the answer. But look how much damage I do. 11. Alright, let's get some good items in the shop. I don't know what this is, so I'm gonna take it. More trinket room. Okay, well, we still need to find a treasure room. But then after that, we can head on out. So was there a... might have been a heart in there. I probably should heal myself, too. I don't know. Linger Bean. We had this one last time. Doesn't do anything. Does nothing useful, at least. Whoa! You know what happened there? I accidentally used my... card. That was dumb. Because my finger slipped. I'll take that. It says there's a heart up there. Oh, it's in here. Well, since I got two trinkets, might as well take poison shots also. Was this? This was Hanged Man. And we will blow this up since I want to get more health. Same with that. Alright, now we're gonna go face Mom. We're doing pretty well in health. Pretty well. Poison shots is nice. And we have a high chance of getting a angel room. The double room's also almost as useful to me too, though, since I have a lot of hearts. Alright, here we go. Nice thing is I can get these rocks destroyed, so I don't have to worry about that issue. Yeah, we do a lot of damage. Very helpful. Isaac. There we go. Range up. Yes, mother. I've unlocked Forgotten Horseman, and I got the Mother Transformation again. So now I got that knife behind me. No boss rush, though. That's okay. Ooh. Sometimes destroying rocks down here will cause them to fire projectiles, which can do damage. So I kind of want to avoid doing that if I can help it. At least in the womb. I just need to be careful, though. Alright, these guys will actually break free eventually, so we want to take them out as fast as we can. Yep, there he goes. Oh, that was blood. I didn't realize it was actually damaging blood. Whatever, we do a lot of damage now. That is a bonus. Could not get out of the way of that one. Or that one. Oh no. Yeah, and there's a lot of them. It's really tough to dodge. Really. So we'll see. I might end up not having enough health. Should be kind of embarrassing, but whatever. Oops. Do a lot of damage. So, it's one good thing, I guess. Alright, there we go, another heart. If we just stay here, we should be alright, except for that leech. So I'm gonna flip to the other side and attack him this way. There we go. Orange tentacles will actually come after you. But, normally the other ones won't. They just are static. Okay, get these guys out of the way, and we're gonna move on. Take that soul heart and go. Mama Gertie! Whoa. I actually am not sure I've ever faced this boss before. But I took it out really easily. Tears and shot speed up and health. So that actually wasn't bad at all. And now we're back to low damage. Envy. The secret here is just to, I mean, I've talked about this before, compartmentalize. Don't try and do them, make them all small. You want to take the small ones first before moving on to larger ones. But this fly is pretty helpful. Nah, I'm not going to try that. I want to keep this with me, though. It'll be useful at some point. Oops. Oops. Well, maybe it's good that I have this damage. We just need to keep on moving. Okay. Since I, you know, it's three hearts to replenish. There's a alright chance that I'll be able to pick that up somehow. But damage is just useful to have. Need to be careful here, though. Okay. These guys are tough. I'm going to try and keep my rocks here just as some barriers. Okay. Alright, Mom. Mom's hands are coming down. Don't forget about that. Looks like there's at least 2, 3, 4. There's a lot of them. Okay. Maybe there weren't that many. Half a heart, thank you. Okay. Soul heart, I will save that. I could use Hangman there. If I don't find a better place, that's probably what I will do. Guys are just really hard to dodge because they open up, or they appear and fire immediately, if they see you, that is. This is going to be helpful there. And I think I probably will use this. Yes, 2 hearts. Thank you. That was a good idea. And just like that, we're about to face the boss. So, make sure we're not missing anything. Pick up my soul heart and move on. Let me see. Okay, I don't think I've beaten anyone with this character. So we might unlock something if we are able to defeat Mom's Heart. It lives. Oh yeah, that's right. If you beat Mom's Heart enough times, you unlock It Lives. And that is where we're at now. Strategy is pretty similar. I think the only real difference is it just spawns different enemies. I don't know, I don't know. It hasn't... I've never really thought of it as a more difficult boss. I am taking some damage, though. I gotta be careful. Okay. Ho-ho. What do we have here? The Blue Womb again. Yeah, look at that. We barely made it in time for the Blue Womb. Should I try it? Why not? I'm sorry, I just have to try it every time I get the opportunity. I know I'm probably gonna die. Plus we have keys, so I'll take that. And this four-way buddy, I guess, is probably a little better. Suits in here. I can buy all of these if I want, and that's what I'm gonna do. Strength. This guy, Mod Buddy, just does random status effects. And let's gamble. Paralysis. Okay, neutral. Alright, with 5 keys, we can go to all of these. Thank you. Or a Boros Worm. Actually, this is going to be, I think, useful to us. Because it gives us huge range. And Hush is a pretty large target. So here we go. Use Strength. If we stay back here, we should be alright. Because his range just doesn't go that far. Well, maybe it does, but I'm barely dodging it. Yes, this is a little bit more difficult. I'm tempted to just drop it. For right now. I'm actually going to do that. So I'm going to drop it, and I'll pick it up as soon as Hush spawns, because I'll have a little bit of time. You can see we just don't do that much damage, though. And that is really going to be the issue. I don't care though, I'm willing to try. Because if... Okay, now I'll pick both of these up. Now the thing is, even if we're, the thing is, since we're dodging, we're still doing damage. So I think, hopefully if I can just dodge long enough, we'll be alright. I'm not doing a lot of damage, but I haven't taken any damage. There we go, now I have. But yeah, there's no secret here. This is a tough fight. A tough fight. It's also an endurance fight. You just have to be focused for a long time. And that makes it hard also. Dodge I don't like to do, and there we go, able to pull it out. Oops. Oh, that's close. Oops. Anytime we take damage, we should take advantage of that and move to a better position. Because we have that small little frame of invincibility. These guys are a little tough to dodge because they're wavy. And they come back. Oh no. We were doing somewhat well, but I think we're not going to make it now. Nope. Alright, well, we got halfway there again. What? Worth a shot. I always like to try. It's RetroGamingNow, playing Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus, and I'll see you guys in the next episode.